In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Rodney and Margaret, the church shares your joy, and warmly welcomes you together with your families and friends. As today in the presence of God our Father, you establish between yourselves a lifelong partnership. May the Lord hear you on this your joyful day. May he send you health from heaven and protection. May he grant you your heart's desire, and fulfill every one of your prayers. Today, as we gather to celebrate with Rodney and Peggy, we come together on the Feast of the Holy Family. And when Rodney and Peggy and I were talking about, you know, when to do the wedding, and I mentioned that this would be the Feast of the Holy Family, they both said almost simultaneously that would be perfect. To come together as families, join into one this new family on the Feast of the Holy Family, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. And so it is a great joy to gather with the two of you today as we call to mind now our sins, asking God for mercy and forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who are pleased to give us the shining example of the Holy Family, graciously grant that we may imitate them in participating in practicing the virtues of family life and in the bonds of charity, and so, in the joy of your house, delight one day in eternal rewards. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and united in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Please be seated for our reading from Sacred Scripture.
A reading from the Book of Sirach. God sets a father in honor over his children, the mother's authority he confirms over her sons. Whoever honors his father atones for sins and preserves himself from them. When he prays, he is heard. He stores up riches who reveres his mother. Whoever honors his father is gladdened by children, and when he prays is heard. Whoever reveres his father will live a long life. He who obeys his father brings comfort to his mother. My son, take care of your father when he is old. Grieve him not as long as he lives. Even if his mind may fail, be considerate to him. Revile him not all the days of his life. Kindness to a father will not be forgotten. Firmly planted against the debt of your sins, a house raised in justice to you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they who dwell in your house, O Lord.
Blessed are they who dwell in your house, O Lord.
How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord of hosts. My soul yearns and pines for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out to the living God.
Blessed are they who dwell in the house of the Lord.
Happy they who dwell in your house. Continually they praise you. Happy the men whose strength you are. Their hearts are set upon the privilege.
Blessed are they who dwell in the house of the Lord.
O Lord of hosts, hear our prayer. Hearken, O God of Jacob. O God, behold our shield and look upon the face of your anointed.
Blessed are they who dwell in the house of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, Christians, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also forgive. And over all these put on love, that is, the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you are also called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs of gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Family and friends and guests to get together.
And so now we're into our new church. This is the second wedding, just in the last couple of months. And I just said, you know, how appropriate. The first wedding was the son of one of the people on the building committee, and now the second wedding is one of the members on the building committee. How appropriate that the first weddings that we have here in our new church are those who helped see to it that it got done. Because if it had been left up to me, I don't know if we would be sitting in here today. I'm a much slower mover, but I did a lot of prodding, and the help of the building committee got us here. Just as a side note, as I mentioned at the beginning, today is the Feast of the Holy Family, and our Mass here this evening for those of you who are Catholic, it does fulfill your obligation for tomorrow. The readings that we heard are the readings for the feast and for the Sunday, and Rodney and maybe wanted that to be a gift to all of you who are Catholic, so that after the party tonight, you can feel free to sleep in tomorrow morning if you so desire. I'm not saying that you shouldn't go to church, however, so you could still go if you wanted to. But you certainly don't have to, because your obligation is fulfilled here tonight. It's been a great pleasure for me over the past 6 years to get to know Rodney, and I would say probably over the past maybe 2 years or so, 3 years, to get to know Maggie. Over this time, we have journeyed many roads together. As I mentioned, the building of the church, but I think even more importantly, the road of spirituality, the journey towards eternal life. I have had the great honor and the privilege of walking with Rodney and Annie over these past, especially the past few months, over these past few years, and helping Rodney to prepare to enter into the Catholic Church, to become a Catholic himself, in preparation for this day. One of the things that Rodney had requested was, he said, I want to be Catholic before I get married. And so we saw to it that we were able to fulfill that wish of Rodney's. So the two of them can come together in this bond, which in the Catholic Church we say is one of our seven sacraments. The sacramental bond of marriage. A bond that unites a man and a woman together in an inseparable way. It's a bond that can never be broken. The only thing that can break the bond of marriage is death itself. And so Rodney and Maggie come together to pledge their love for one another and to enter into this holy, this sacred union of marriage. The Feast of the Holy Family. We are reminded through our scriptures that we listen to tonight of the importance of living that life of holiness. And in our second reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians, St. Paul reminds us and tells us some of the things that are required of us to be a holy family, to be holy. To be holy, we have to have heartfelt compassion. We have to be compassionate towards one another. Compassion is part of the center of holiness. We must be kind to one another. We must practice that kindness that St. Paul speaks of. We must be humble, gentle, and patient. We must be willing to bear with one another and to forgive one another. We recognize in all of our lives that we make mistakes. We're going to make mistakes along the way. And the only way to get over those mistakes that we make is to forgive. We must be willing to forgive one another. Just as St. Paul tells us, just as the Lord has forgiven us. Rodney and Maggie, the two of you are starting a new family. It will be the family of Rodney and Maggie Gray. This wonderful feast day, during this most sacred and holy time of year, is a great reminder to us that call to live that life of holiness. Are you going to do it perfectly? No, there's not one of us in this church that can live that life of holiness perfectly, especially not as perfectly as does the holy family of Mary, Jesus, and Joseph. However, Mary, Jesus, and Joseph are given to us as a model. We are to constantly strive to live that type of life, that life of holiness, a life of holiness that calls us to constantly strive to do God's will, to put God's will first in our life. Rodney, you are called to be like Joseph. Joseph was an upright and righteous man. Joseph always sought first and foremost what was best for my wife. What is best for Mary? How can I best care for her? How can I best nurture her? How can I best take care of my son Jesus, whom God the Father entrusted to me to take care of? You are called upon, Rami, to be like Joseph, an upright, righteous man, willing to take care of me and to take care of your family. Your family, which now is going to more than double in size, once the two of you are married, with your own children, as well as your stepchildren and their spouses and grandchildren, all come together in this one beautiful, holy, yet not quite perfect family. Maybe you are to look towards Mary. Look at her as your role model, as a mother. Now Mary has an advantage over us, in that she was born without sin. But nevertheless, she is that role model for you. Look to her when it comes to how you respond to Rodney. Mary responded to Joseph with great love, with great devotion, with heartfelt mercy. Her love for Joseph was incredible, so much so that she was willing to journey with him wherever the road were to be. Mary also took great care of her son Jesus. Likewise, just as for Rodney, for you, to be that mother for your children and Rodney's children, for your grandchildren, to love them with a mother's love, to love them with that heartfelt compassion, with mercy, with kindness, that whole list of beautiful tributes, of beautiful ways of living that St. Paul spoke of in our second reading. Living a life of holiness is not impossible. It's very possible. But it takes work. As husband and wife, take time to pray together. Take time to pray over sacred scripture. Read the scriptures. Pray memorized prayer. Pray spontaneous prayer. But spend time together as husband and wife in prayer. Prayer is what will lead you most dearly to the heart of Jesus. In a little while, after you have exchanged your vows, and you have exchanged your rings, and the two of you become one flesh, you're going to come over and you're going to light your unity candle. You're going to take your two individual candles, which represent your baptismal candles. It represents that the two of you were entered into the life of the church through the waters of baptism. Way back, actually, maybe I shouldn't say the year, but back in the 60s, let's say, for both of you, when you were both baptized, maybe at the cathedral in Princeton, and Rodney, when you were baptized, was that, I believe, in Raleigh? Was that Berwick? In Berwick, North Dakota. At that moment of your life, you entered into the life of Christ. These two individual candles represent that time of your baptism. And Rodney's going to light the two individual candles from the Christ candle. This candle, whatever it burns in the church, represents to us that Christ is here present. And so when they light the individual candles from the Christ candle, it represents that it is through the light of Christ that the two of them are going to become one. So they take the two individual baptismal candles, they light the unity candle for that very powerful symbol of the two, through the power of Christ, through his light, becoming one flesh. The two of you are about to give each other the greatest gift that you will probably ever give to each other, the gift of your very self. Live your life in a life of holiness. When you stumble, if you fall, forgive one another. Show mercy, compassion, and understanding. Always love one another. And realize that the journey that you are on is not necessarily just an earthly journey, but the journey that you are on is a heavenly journey. For one of the greatest responsibilities of a husband to a wife and a wife to her husband is to lead one another to the joys of God's heavenly kingdom. And that requires a life of faith, a life of love, a life of compassion and understanding. Take your bookmarks, they're beautiful, by the way, that you have, and that the three kids did such a beautiful job proclaiming before the beginning of our service. Have that handy. Put that in your Bible. Put that in your favorite book that you like to read. Or if you have a book that you use for prayer and meditation, put that in there. Use that as a source of your prayer. for that reading that the kids proclaim so beautifully is what it takes to lead one another to the joys of God's heavenly kingdom. Remain faithful to each other and all around. Let your love so shine through the two of you that your children and your grandchildren will come to know the love of Christ, because they know the love that you have for one another. May God bless you today and every day of your married life together as you journey towards His heavenly kingdom.
You have come together to the house of the church, so that in the presence of the church's minister and this community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with the sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, He enriches and strengthens those He has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Rodney and Margaret, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly? Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other in a holy life for as long as you both shall live? Since it's your intention to enter into marriage, join your hands and declare your consent before God and His church. I Rodney take you, Margaret, to be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life. I'm Margaret to take you, Rodney.
I'm Margaret
to take you, Rodney.
To be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and
in
bad.
In sickness and in health. To love you and to honor you. All the days of my life. Maybe, Rodney, may the Lord this time strengthen your consent to declare before the church, and graciously agree to fulfill it as blessing to me. What God has joined together, let no one separate. May the Lord bless these rings, which you give to each other, as a sign of your love and fidelity. Margaret, take this ring. As a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Rodney, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
and we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, that they may live in unity with one another, always showing mercy and compassion towards one another, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, that they may experience God's healing hand in their lives and find peace and comfort in their struggles, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Marie Ron Snyder, Donnie Snyder, and family and friends of Rocky and Amy, that they may now share eternal life with us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving and gracious God, we give you thanks and praise for the many gifts and blessings you bestow upon us, in a special way this night, for the gift of love between God and man. We humbly ask God that you hear these prayers that we offer, for we offer them in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated while our altar is prepared.
Thank you.
and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. We offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of reconciliation, humbly asking that through the intercession of the Virgin Mother of God and Saint Joseph, her spouse, you may establish our families firmly in your grace and your peace. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just,
our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ, your Son, our Lord. For on the feast of this awe-filled mystery, through though invisible in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in others, and begotten before all ages, he has begun to exist in time, so that raising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call straying humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your
Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Behold the Lamb of God, who has commanded in the sacrament of marriage, Rodney and Megan. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called in the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Bring those who refresh with the Seventy Sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, we may share their company forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before we have our final lesson for Megan and for Rabbi, and our final lesson for everyone, Greg, I just want to say a couple of thank yous. First of all, I want to thank Rabbi and Megan for allowing me to journey with the two of you. It's been such a great pleasure for me to get to know you better and to become part of your lives and especially your faith journey. The two of you have a beautiful thing for you. You have a beautiful relationship. You have a beautiful love for one another. And God richly blesses that love tonight. And because of your love for one another, God richly blesses all of us. So I just want to thank you for allowing me again to be part of your faith journey and your journey of love as an husband. I also want to thank our musicians, Mary Jane, Marie, and Lily. The music was absolutely beautiful. Your singing voice, Marie, is outstanding. I could just sat there and listen to you. Just keep that obviously above. And Lily, over there she is, with the cello and the violin, you guys did that duet. That was absolutely beautiful. So thank you very much for sharing your gifts, Mary Jane, for sharing your gift of music. Also want to thank Lila, there she is. She did our host, our prelude, Joy to the World, and beautifully done for two Lila. As well as Jack, Lila, and Anna for their beautiful proclamation of St. Paul's writings to the Corinthians that they did before our wedding. You kids have a great gift in proclamation. And so thank you for sharing that with us this evening. To all of you, friends and family of Rabbi and Megan, on behalf of Rabbi and Megan, we thank you for being here tonight, for coming to celebrate this beautiful celebration, in which we give praise and thanks to God for the gift of these two, this newlywed couple. Is there anything else that you want to thank at this time? We have our rector, the ministers, all those who participated, our server, Damien, so our Sean and Herbert, witnessing Mary officially, all the family and friends. Thank you all very much. Hopefully you'll be able to join us for the reception that we have at the Brookston Inn over at Brookston. Is that have a starting time? They may remain faithful in the
May the grace of love and peace abide in your heart and heart, and let it always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the sacred scriptures. May Rodney, her husband, entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir of the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his bride, the Church. And now, Lord, I implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments. May one in the flesh, may they be blameless in all they do. And with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. Grant that reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed and the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May they love you. May God, the eternal Father, keep you of one heart and love one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. May you be blessed in your children and in your grandchildren. Have solace in your friends and enjoy true peace with everyone. May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal love of God. Now may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. It is a privilege and honor to be present to you, Rodney and Margaret Grimm.